يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The punishment will be doubled for those people. The passage began, these are special people to me. And now Allah says, these kaba'ir, these three things, shirk, murder, and zina, adultery, illegitimate relations, these three things, if a Muslim does it, anybody else does it, they will get punished. A Muslim does it, I'll punish him double. He knew it and he still did it. The mushrik, at least he didn't know and he did it. The Muslim knew it and he still did it. يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. On Judgment Day, on Resurrection Day, the punishment is doubled for him. وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا. And he will remain in that punishment humiliated. He will constantly be humiliated. Because shirk and killing a person and zina are humiliating crimes. They take away the dignity of a human being. And so Allah Azza wa Jalla is extremely angry at these people. Then you're like, maybe somebody sitting in this audience that's made some mistakes in their life. Don't raise your hand. Only Allah knows your mistakes. I don't want to know. And you shouldn't tell people. It's between you and Allah. Maybe you've made some big mistakes in your life. What about you? You hear these ayahs are like, oh my God, double punishment. Maybe I should leave the masjid right now because that's pretty depressing. And then shaitan comes to those kinds of people. You know what shaitan says to them? Man, you going to hell anyway. Might as well party it up. You know, what are you doing in the masjid anymore? You're already on the express train. Just go all the way, man. You know, you're already a goner. What does Allah say about these people? إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. The exception is people who did shirk, people who did murder, people who did zina. But the exception is even if you did these things or all of these things, if you turn back to Allah, and you became a believer again. It's like you became a new Muslim. You came into Islam all over again. And this time, وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. And he was very serious about doing good things from now on. It's not just عَمِلَ صَالِحًا. يَقُولُ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. نُسَمِّي هَذَا الْمَفْعُولَ الْمُطْلَقُ. This is called the absolute additive. It's added to the verb to emphasize it over anything else. What that means in simple English is, this person came back, returned back to Allah, fixed their faith, and then after fixing their faith, this time they take their actions very seriously. They take their actions very, very seriously. They are really keen on doing good deeds. عَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. If you can become that person, even if you've done some terrible things in your life, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Then those people, Allah will take all of their sins and convert them into good deeds. He will not just get rid of your sins. We want Allah to get rid of our sins. Maybe your sins are the size of a mountain. I don't want to see that mountain on Judgment Day. Allah will not get rid of the mountain. Allah will turn the mountain into a mountain of good deeds if you can make tawbah. This is Ar-Rahman.